Hi, and welcome back to the Life License Qualification Program video series. Again, my name is Jason Watt, and what we're going to spend the next few minutes doing is working through a implementation of a group insurance contract. Now, in order to see the implementation of this group insurance contract, let's look at our sample business. We'll come up with a little business here that might be interested in acquiring group insurance. So here's what we're going to work with. We have, let's say, Susan. And Susan owns a bookshop that specializes in distributing rare books. She does some of her business in her store, and she does some of her business online, like a lot of businesses today. So Susan is the 100% owner of the business. And Susan has one manager who works for her. One full-time manager. In addition, we have five employees who work in the bookstore itself. They run the till, they work the shifts, they stock the shelves, all the kind of stuff we need when we have a retail location. And then in addition to the five employees who work in the store, she has one webmaster, the person who actually operates her website for her. She has one book appraiser. Her book appraiser is the person who handles the actual estimations, the values of the books. This is a fairly specialized skill. We'll talk more about that in a few minutes. Although it doesn't relate specifically to group insurance, I'm going to use this opportunity to fast forward a little bit and look at something that you'll discuss again in Module 15. We will also, within the store, have one shipper receiver. And we will have our bookkeeper as well. Susan herself handles the majority of the sales, doesn't have a hands-on role in management so much anymore. She's passed on most of that management responsibility to her full-time manager. So we have a fairly small company here with five employees in the store plus four other folks, plus our two managers, a total of 11 people working in the store. Now, why would Susan want group insurance? Well, maybe she herself has some expenses that she'd like to deal with. Maybe she has a sick child, or maybe she personally has some medical expenses, and maybe she'd like a hand taking care of those. We can generate some tax efficiency by having the business pay for those expenses. When the business pays for those expenses, it's tax deductible to the business, but we end up with a benefit accruing in the plan member's hands. So that's a very tax efficient way to spend our money. If we have to take the money out of the business and then spend it, what you'll find is the business will be taxed on those dollars. If Susan takes them out as dividends, or if she takes it as salary, then she'll be taxed at the full marginal tax rate, as you've seen, back in Module 5. So, not very tax efficient for her to spend that money out of her own pocket. Instead, what she might prefer to do is to have the business acquire a group benefits plan, and that way she can actually deduct those expenses for the business, and she receives most of those benefits tax-free herself. The same would apply for any of her employees. So maybe she's thinking of herself. Maybe she's thinking of the company, though. Maybe she says, you know what, we've seen a lot of turnover here amongst our employees. They're not particularly well compensated. They're mostly retail workers, and we don't want to pay them a huge wage, but we know that they would attach a fairly high value to having group insurance. Maybe if they knew they had a drug plan in place, or they knew they had a dental care plan, those types of things. We might end up with more employee loyalty, more retention, and then our management wouldn't have to spend so much time going out and finding new employees. So that might be a reason why we're going to get group insurance. And for a group of this size, that's probably really what we're looking at. In a smaller group, we might be doing it for Susan's tax efficiency, but in a larger group like this, we're probably looking at how we're going to help to attract and retain employees. Even for these folks out here who might be better paid, they're also in jobs where there might be somebody else looking to snatch them up. That is, there might be other jobs out there for these folks, and Susan wants to stay competitive. She offers them group benefits. It's just one more incentive to get them to stick around. So what do? Well, we go to Susan and we say, okay, Susan, we understand that you want group benefits. Susan says, yeah, absolutely. And we might be dealing with Susan or her manager. It depends who she's delegated authority to. So then we're going to ask for some information. And what really happens here is we pass around an employee data sheet of some sort, and we're going to gather information about typically the ages, the genders, the marital status, and maybe the smoking status and number of kids for each of these employees. With only 11 people in the group, we are going to have some concerns about their mortality and morbidity. So we gather in this information. We gather the information about the 11 employees. One more thing we might look at is, do any of them belong to plans already? Maybe one of our retail workers here is married to somebody who has a group benefits plan. We might be considering those things already when we're deciding how many people are actually going to get insured. As mentioned earlier in the videos, if one of these people has a spouse who has group benefits, they could opt out of the plan without hurting the plan necessarily. So it depends what information exactly we gather, but it's going to be something along those lines. So we gather in that information, and then what's going to happen is we're going to take that information, and in most situations, this is not universally true, but in most situations, people selling group insurance will deal with a variety of different insurers. So then what we'll do is we'll go shop that information around. We might go get quotes from five or six different insurers, and we bring those quotes back in, and the quotes will help us to assess what types of benefits Susan's going to look at. Now,